Here we go. Oh my gosh.
Watch what happens when this semi truck gets stuck on a train track.
Messing with the wrong cracker. I'm telling you, I'm trucker mother. Oh! Come on! Yeah! Yeah, that's why you upside down in the median.
going backwards. That's the scary part. You still have no brakes going backwards.
Oh, dude. Oh, he's going to tip. Tipped. Did he tip?
Minnesota State Patrol reported the crash involved ultimately 7 vehicles, 5 passenger cars, and 2 semi-trucks, including 1 semi-truck, which obviously jackknifed. The southbound lanes were closed for approximately 2 hours before one lane was reopened. Incredibly, there were no injuries reported with the pileup. A closer analysis of this crash event shows how the median cable barrier helped prevent serious injuries by preventing several cars, including both semis, from going into oncoming lanes. While the barrier did limit some lateral movement for the vehicles, it ultimately played a major role in preventing more significant forces from being involved.
This guy is gonna wreck.
Yo, you want to see something cool? No. Well, I'm going to do it anyway.
Step into the scene! Valió pura verga. Valió pura verga. Valió pura verga, verga.
Is everyone okay?
I think so. There's everybody's out, I think.
Okay. Oh my god.
I don't know who's in this car, but it's empty.
Oh my god.
But
what's
you
yours?
The cab used to sit up
what's
here.
Yours?
I'm back there.
Oh, okay.
We actually stopped right behind the last
oh my
the
god.
Semi with the back end that's all beat up.
That's crazy.
But he got lucky.
Yeah.
Truck crashes into all the Toyota cars to see which is the strongest. Toyota 4Runner. Only the person in the trunk survived. 2019 Toyota Corolla. It got completely flattened. 2022 Toyota Tacoma. The people in the back seat may have a chance. 2021 Toyota Supra. The Supra didn't stand a chance. 2014 Toyota Highlander. It's actually pretty strong for an SUV. Toyota MR2. It got vaporized.